Question 35. Just incidentally, I do check every about 5 questions to make sure I'm giving you the right answers. And so far, I've been doing really good. Got a few errors, you know, little things. So I get those fixed before I publish the videos. Anyway, we're asked to solve for x. So this is going to be a combination of solving equations using logarithm properties and also what I like to call the log dance. So let me just show you what I call the log dance, and that is the property that if we have the log of some base, let's use a, I guess, and we have some input, right? Let's use b equals some value. The log dance is that we can change this to exponential simply by moving things around. So these are 3 items. There's a base to the logarithm, which is actually going to be the base of an exponential function. The answer to a logarithm, as we sort of been seeing, is actually an exponent. So this is a to the c. And then the input is what the output becomes. So the input of a logarithm is the output of an exponential function. The input of an exponential function is the exponent. That's the output of a log function. This is how an inverse works. You might have seen with addition, a plus b equals c. To do this as an inverse, what you switch this over is you're going to get that if a plus b equals c, then if you take c and subtract either a or b, doing the opposite operation, you get back to b. So c minus a will give you b. That's how inverses work. So I look at it as a dance. So we've got 2 items being combined to give us a third to get the inverse, sort of the backward operation. We just combine the other 2. And so that's the little dance that goes on. So first of all, I guess what we could start here before we do too much, we could subtract 7 from both sides because the 7's not even involved in the logarithm yet. So we get 0 here. Over here we get 9 minus 7, which is 2. And then I'm going to write it down here. We get log base 4 of minus 5x equals 2. Okay, so that's what happens. Now we're ready to do the log dance. We've got this logarithm, and notice the base of the logarithm is going to be the base of an exponential function. The answer of the logarithm, this output, is going to become the input of the logarithm, so 4 to the second power equals whatever's put inside the input, so minus 5x. Wow, logarithm is completely gone. This log dance got rid of it. But we've got 4 squared, which is 16, equals negative 5x. And now we just got a linear equation. Divide both sides by negative 5. And we've got our answer. X equals 16 over 5. Don't forget the negative part. We'll put that out front or put it somewhere. Maybe put it up there. So this could blend it in. So negative 16 fifths is what our answer to x is. And they do give us this fraction key, so we'll go ahead and use that. We'll put the negative first, and again, if you put it up in the top, that would be okay, or in the bottom, but it needs to be negative 16 fifths. Okay, so we solve that. That's our answer.